What's up, y'all? How are you doing today? This is Hussein Nasser from iGeometry. Let us continue with our beautiful calculator. This is the JavaScript by example series where we build stuff using the tools of JavaScript, right? As always, put your mind to it. You're building an app. You're building something. And programming tools are just, it's just tools. And you're using them. And what we have been doing so far, man, we did that, right? We built the UI. We have almost a complete user interface. We added events. Oh, look at that. When we click on certain buttons, we now add those to this sticks. That is cool. What we did not do, which we will do in this episode, is actually add code to clear and add these operations. And hopefully we can also equivalate the results as well. So yeah, let's get this. Even zero, the zero, we didn't add that. So that will be tricky. All right, so there is a lot of, we'll find a lot of bugs in the process, but we're gonna fix them slowly. All right, let's get to work. Okay, open your calc.html. Obviously, guys, you'll find the code from the, this will be in this description. You will see the latest code at the end of this episode. So go back to the previous episode, grab the code from the previous episode and then continue on, right? So that will be episode 3. This is episode 4. All right, what do we do, man? Look at all this code, man. When we learn about loops, we will shrink this code, right? We will we'll make it more compact, make it more neat. All right, so what are we missing, man? We're missing adding these puppies, right? If we click on these, nothing happens. That's because we did not listen on those events. Let's go ahead and create subtraction document.getElementById. What did we call this sub? All right, we called it sub. By the way, there is another way to know. If you right click on this and you do inspect any web page, really, you can find the ID really easily. So it's sub. And then on sub.addEventListener, right, print symbol. And yeah, let's just do that. And then we're going to add the rest. So 9 minus, nice, 9. Look at that. Sweet. All right. Let's add the plus, get element by ID, plus, and then plus.addEventListener, click print symbol. Yeah, don't accidentally add those, huh, guys? Maybe I'll hide my picture here, but yeah, don't accidentally add those. That'll become problematic for you. I think there is mult, let mult equal document.getElementById, mult. And then I believe it's called dev. What is that? Is it called mult? And then dev, it's really called dev. Mult.addEventListener on click, just print the same symbol. So we're calling the same function and it's doing great for us, but certain function will need to do different. And last one, dev is equal document, division. And on the division, click print symbol. Save, refresh. What do we have, man? 9 multiplied by 9 minus 6 plus 3 divided by 2. Nice, look at that. That is so cool. And then we'll need an equal. That will be in, we'll see. We'll need to do the dot. It's very important. And we'll need to do the zero. We didn't do those two. So what is the dot? What is the ID of that puppy? It's called decimal. Decimal it is. Let decimal equal document.getElementDecimal. And then decimal. Click. We're just printing. Nothing special. Just print those symbols. And zero. What do we call you? Zero. Zero is num zero. Num zero equal document or get element by ID num zero. And then after we get the num zero. I only added it at the beginning because it doesn't, I just wanted to organize it because you, obviously you can add it at the end, doesn't matter. But it's just for having the app have a neat look. All right, so why is this? Yeah, that's because only three characters. Okay, all right, looks good. Refresh. 9 multiplied by 6 minus 3 plus 2 minus 1. Look at that. Minus 6.3 plus 6. Nice. Look at that. All right. We're going to show you a list of bugs that we will fix. This is the first bug. Zero, if you add zero to a zero, it's just zero, right? You can't, we should not keep adding zeros, right? So we will solve this with something called conditions or if statements, right? If there is a zero, don't add another zero to it because it doesn't make any sense. So multiplication, that's okay, but another problem is that this is not an operation, right? This is, doesn't make any sense, but yeah, we're allowing that. And the another thing is this. That's because we don't have a fixed size. We have an auto size. And as we add, our calculator gets fatter and fatter. Look at that. Full bodied. It's a full body. It's not that. Yeah. Look at that. All right. So last thing we want to do in this episode before we end it, and for the next episode we're going to do the equivalent, is actually clear. All right, that, so that will require different function to do that. So let's go ahead and add a clear. What do we call it? Clear? Did we call it? What did we call that function? Man, we called it clear. How about that? It's called clear. So let's go ahead and pull that. So that all those point to the same function. They execute the same code. It's always take me, the one I clicked on, which is E, whatever I have as a content, just display it. So it's simple. But now when I click on AC or clear, I want to do something different. So let's do that. Clear is equal document dot get element by ID. Nope. By ID. Clear. And then we'll do that. Clear.add event listener. Click. Now we can do two things here. We can create another function called clear, or we can actually introduce a new inline function, or we call it expression here. So let's just introduce that as the title of this series. So like we're gonna call this arrow functions. Yeah, why not? Let's introduce this another type of functions called arrow functions. An arrow function are appropriate if you have one single line of code, like in our case, where when we want to clear this text, it's literally take the result, right, which is this, and set it to zero. So it's actually one line of code. So we will have to have that line of code executed in this statement. So to do that is you basically provide the parameter, which is this E, and then you'll add an arrow. And then what you will do is basically execute that command, which is document.getElementById results dot text content is equal to zero. And that's like that, we're done. Do you see that, guys? You can, by the way, add another line here. It doesn't really matter, JavaScript. So take some time, ask questions if you want to know more about this. This is another function type. So this is one way to do it, right? So E is equal document, or I just added this parameter. We don't really use it here, but I'll tell you in a second now. Let's see if that actually did the trick. So 9999999 AC. Woo! Look at that. It actually worked. How about that? So that's how actually we do this. Another way, remember? So again, you can do whatever you want. So there is another function called clear. You can do it this way. And then you can do the exact same thing that we did here. Text content is equal zero. And just like that, let's comment out this line so we can show you that there are multiple ways of doing things in programming. So we can do that and just literally call clear. So you can write that function up and call it from here, or you can use it in line. So let's see if that works. Looks like we broke things, guys, here. What did we break? Yeah, we definitely broke something. We definitely broke something, guys. We broke something. Oop, nothing's working. Okay, so that's time for debugging. What happened here? Clear has already been declared. That is right, because we called this function. So what we saw here is actually good. So we used clear as a function name, and we also use it as a variable name, and does the app got confused. So we recalled it to clear screen again. So let's just do that now. Nine, things are working again. That's good. And then we click this, and that works again. So you have this option, or you can do it the arrow way function, the arrow function. I was about to say arrowhead, the water. But yeah, that's why we do it. E is really optional here because we didn't really use it. I don't really care about that object AC, so that's one way to do it. Another one way to do it was as we just did here, which is that. I'd like to start using this, right? E. Again, we didn't use that, so if you didn't use any variable, you can just replace it with an empty string. So that's another way of writing an arrow function. Another way of writing an arrow function, you can write an arrow function here, assign it to a variable, but let's take it slow here. So now we just introduced another function. Optionally, you can use it if you want. It's just reading that line, you can see what the function does. And instead of, oh, print symbol, oh, I have to go. What does print symbol do, you know? So that's just two ways of doing things if you really prefer it. So I'm gonna comment out this code. I don't believe I explained what comment does. Commenting is a way of explaining the code by saying and freeform text, like, oh, this prints out symbol on the calculator screen, right? So you can type whatever you want, and the code will be ignored. This will never be executed. So, and you can comment out a bulk of code that you don't want the code to be executed. Just take it out, right? So yeah, so what do we, I think we will stop here. So we have our nice functions here. We have a lot of bugs, but we'll fix them. And we have decimals. We don't have equal yet. We're gonna do that in the next episode, but we did a clear, that's cool. And yeah, there's another bug here where if you hit 9 or 6 and there is a 0, it will always add the 0, which is really doesn't make sense, right? I think we talked about this. Like if you click here and you add 9, it doesn't add a 0. So we need to fix that. We need to remove that. Really, we're not gonna use a negative or positive here really, because we can just use these as an expression. So, and we're gonna replace them with parentheses. A very important functionality. Okay, next episode, evaluating that actual equation that we're gonna write and displaying the results. Stay tuned. Subscribe to so you guys don't miss anything. And I'm gonna see you in the next one. Goodbye.